Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome, dear learners. This is a video for the subject of education for the course of Bachelor's in Education and for the paper of Child Development and Learning. This video is going to cover a very important topic, which is learning, unlearning, and relearning. This video has been recorded by Professor Jaseem Ahmed. The course coordinator for this video is Dr. Iram Khan from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. She is also the academic expert or the reviewer for this video. The presenter or the subject matter expert for this video is Professor Jaseem Ahmed from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. This video is produced under the project DTH Swayam Prabha Channels of MHRD, New Delhi.
Hello, dear learners. I am Jaseem Ahmed from IASE Faculty of Education, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Today, we are going to discuss on the topic learning, unlearning, and relearning. And the objectives of today's discussion are to discuss the concept of learning, unlearning, and relearning. We will also try to describe the significance of unlearning in the process of academic growth, and we will discuss the role of unlearning in improving our understanding and achievements. We shall also discuss some of the examples pertaining to the process of learning, unlearning, and relearning. So friends, let's start with one of the very famous quote of Alvin Toffler, who says, "The illiterate of the 21st century will not be the ones who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn and unlearn and relearn." We must remember that the secret to learn new things is to be willing to unlearn, even if what you know previously brought success for you. Friends, try to understand what is learning and unlearning. Learning is the process of acquiring new or modifying existing knowledge, behaviors, skills, values, perceptions, and preferences. Human beings have the exceptional ability to learn and perform in different capacities and at different levels of perfection. Some learning is immediate, induced by a single event, but much skill and knowledge accumulates from repeated experiences. Unlearning is to make an effort to forget or avoid your usual way of doing something so that you can learn a new and sometimes better ways of performance. You must remember, I had to unlearn the way I batted in the state level cricket matches when I started playing for India. You must have experience of this kind, that whatever you have learned in the past, you have to forget them, you have to unlearn them so that you can have new learning and you can achieve new heights in that particular field of knowledge. So learning is an art of knowing, understanding, and internalizing concepts. A concept can be real or imaginary, but is something that contributes to knowledge, that is the idea of entire reality. Unlearning is overriding or basically shelving of already learned concepts in favor of evidence that contradicts the same. For example, children's idea or concept that Earth is flat to the new concept that Earth is not flat, but it is elliptical in shape. Let us discuss some of the important points related to learning, unlearning, and relearning. We can only learn and evolve if we are open-minded and willing to let go of anything that might be holding us back, whether this is an old experience, habit, or method. This doesn't mean that we forget and discard old knowledge, but instead embrace new ideas, approaches, and skills so that we can develop further in our different activities and different skills and different domain of knowledge. It may seem counter-initiative, but the key is to not be deliberate about unlearning. Just replace the old with the new, and the unlearning will happen automatically by itself. Here is an example for your understanding. For example, you want to overcome a long-standing coffee drinking habit. Instead of obsessing over the act of giving up coffee, focus all your attention on drinking water. Do that each time you reach out for that cup of coffee. Slowly, you will find yourself thinking of the water more and the coffee less. And this way, you will unlearn coffee drinking habit. It's really that simple. An open mind and a commitment to new ideas is all it takes. Let us understand what is learn, unlearn, and relearn. This is more to do with the dynamic times and how one is expected to be abreast of the latest in their domains. Gone are the days of work hard and play the rules to become successful. This was only in the pre-internet era. Today, with the rise of internet, smartphones, and globalization, one needs to consistently evolve his strategies, unlearn what worked well in the past, and set the tone for relearning. The best example of individuals who follow learn, unlearn, and relearn are entrepreneurs. They are the restless people, passionate about their ideas, and committed to make it big. They do not hesitate to mend their ways, explore the unknowns, and even pivot their business model so as to build a successful business. So friends, let's discuss the pillars of learning, unlearning, and relearning. So you can see in the diagram, there are four important pillars of learning, unlearning, and relearning. The first one is the complex problem solving. The second one is the cognitive flexibility. The third one is the creative thinking. And the fourth one is critical thinking. We will discuss one by one about all these four pillars of. These four C's, in fact, lie at the core of solving any modern day problems. Let's see how it works. So number one is complex problem solving. In the case of any complex problem solving, a deep understanding of the problem leads to better solution. Asking the right question is a good start to better define the problem statement. The second one is cognitive flexibility. Extensive research is a crucial step in any problem-solving situation. This research can include reading books, journals, and reports to analyze data and organize findings. This is where cognitive flexibility has a huge role to play. In fact, the more flexibility you have in your cognitive process, the more chances is to have better understanding and having, you know, multi-dimensional thinking, or you can say that thinking different ways to go beyond the central point. This refers to the ability to disengage from one task and respond to another and engage with multiple concepts at the same time. It manifests the ability to learn more quickly, solve problems more creatively, and adapt and respond to new situations more effectively. So the third C is creativity. Creativity is one of the most important attributes of the personality of an individual. Nowadays, in a globalized world, in a multinational world, in a world where creative people are in demand, the person, the employees who are having more creative abilities, they are in high demand in the multinational companies. Creativity is a phenomenon whereby something new and somehow valuable is formed. The created item may be intangible, such as an idea, a scientific theory, a musical composition, or a riddle, or a physical object, such as an invention, a printed literary work, or a painting. The fourth C is critical thinking. Critical thinking is quite simply the process of evaluating arguments and evidence to reach the most appropriate and valid conclusion or solution. In another way, you can say that critical thinking is another very important attribute of the personality of an individual, And you can say that the person who are having more critical in their approach, they are generally found to be more creative in nature, and they can solve problem in different ways. So the creative people and the people having critical thinking are more prone to solve problems in a meaningful way, in an efficient way, in an effective way, and of course through a speedy process also. Since critical thinking is a dynamic and reflective process, the ability to unlearn and relearn is crucial to the process. Without critical thinking, one cannot move towards creativity. So, critical thinking works as the backbone for creativity. So, friends, we must be open in our approach. Unlearning doesn't require you to toss out all your accumulated experiences or presume previous know-how will keep you away from success. Rather, it asks that you stay open to different ways of getting things done. It paves way for divergent thinking and search for alternative solutions of a problem, alternate ways of doing and accomplishing a particular task in more efficient manner. Friends, let's discuss about another important topic, which is learn, unlearn, and relearn to become better leaders. As individuals, we are in a constant state of adaptation today. One needs to question assumptions about how things work, challenge the old ways, and relearn what is now relevant in their job, profession, or career. Learning the new ways will ensure one is honing his skills and is improving as he climbs the rank. This approach helps build better leaders who are well prepared to adapt to change at work, driven by business decisions or growth, while the non-adaptive ones scramble to figure out where to go. Lifelong learners are the ones who can maintain momentum and productivity even in case of radical change at work. They can work easily in global team tasks and countries, a much needed skill set for global companies. Let's see how this applies to the life of a communications professional. If we look at the world of communications, there has been a sea of change over the past few years. This has primarily been driven by the rise of digital media, the need for strategic thinking to break through the clutter, and the increased collaboration across markets. There is a need for us as communications professionals to revisit the tried and tested strategies, keeping in mind the current market scenario and the key factors that influence it. While experience continues to be an important asset, it is equally important to get the best from the learning and reuse them in the new scenario. One needs to devise an impactful and differentiated communication strategy that resonates well with the target audience. To give an example, a conventional PR strategy will not be impactful in today's times unless bundled with new age and digital PR. Digital storytelling and a strategy that cuts across a range of influencers, storytelling and personalization, which may not have been very important a few years back, have now become critical to the success of a communications campaign. Also, integrated communications campaigns across all touch points are the key. Today, let us discuss some of the examples of learning, unlearning, and relearning. So the first example in this regard is that many children are observed that they learn and develop the habit of wearing sandals wrongly. That is, left foot sandal in right foot and vice versa. We, the parents, siblings, and teachers, on observing this trend, try to make the child unlearn the wrong habit and transform it into positive ones. That is, relearning the right habit. Example number two. It is also observed that children during their growing stage develop the habit of holding pen in their left hand and also start writing with their left hand. They don't prefer to write using right hand. But it is our social norm that people in general write through right hands, except those who are lefty in their habit. There is no harm in using left hand for writing, but it looks awkward as it is not a general practice in our society. So we, the parents and caretakers, try to make the child unlearn the habit of writing from left hand and relearning of writing using their right hand. Let's discuss some other examples. Any unpleasant behavior or habit learned by children or adolescents or even adults may be unlearned, and a new positive behavior contrary to the previous one may be relearned through various measures. For example, smoking may be turned into non-smoking behavior through willpower and alternative measures. Similarly, drug addiction may be turned into, drug de-addiction through rehabilitation centers and other strategies or treatments. In the process of learning to draw a diagram, you followed a strategy and a step-by-step procedure. Initially, you learn to draw this diagram. After its completion, you analyze the entire process and thought that it may be done following some other steps in a better way. Now you are drawing the same diagram but using different strategies and step-by-step procedure. In the process, you are basically unlearning the previous strategy and relearning the new one. This way, the process of learning, unlearning, and relearning goes on throughout our academic and professional life, and we continue to improve upon in our state of affairs. Let us discuss about unlearning and forgetting and try to understand how these two are different. As verbs, the difference between unlearn and forget is that unlearn is to discard the knowledge of something, while forget is to lose remembrance of something. Forgetting is unintentionally leaving something behind, to cease remembering. Unlearning is purposeful knowledge loss, whereas forgetting is involuntary knowledge loss. Unlearning is the process of discarding something from your memory. When you unlearn something, you forget it, put it aside, and you lose knowledge of that. To discard something from one's memory requires an active forgetting of the thing to be unlearned. Not only does one make an effort to replace the undesirable habits and thought patterns with a collection of new behaviors, but one also ensures that the undesirable habits do not make a reappearance. In other words, the new behaviors must be practiced until they override the old ones. If we treat the human brain like a computer, then we might view unlearning as the analog to Control Z, the undo function. Suppose you are working on a PowerPoint presentation and make some changes to the slides which you find unsatisfactory. It is safe to assume when you hit undo and rework a new copy that you don't want and traces of the bad copy anywhere in your final presentation. The problem is that our brain cannot suddenly switch on these changes like a computer. Let us talk about unlearning the truth. Out of the all talks on unlearning, perhaps the worst is to unlearn the truth. Like mathematical truths are simply not unlearned. Otherwise, they would not be truths in the first place. For example, we may not be doing geometry in the same way as the ancient Greeks did. So, perhaps in a sense, we have unlearned the original methods and terminology, but the theorems still hold. So, the truth remains the truth. Hence, thinking more generally, it is still not more reasonable to unlearn truth. Beware of fake news and propaganda. It is another very important strategy to maintain the truth. Reading the description, the intention is to motivate us to think critically and to prevent ourselves falling into the traps of fake news, propaganda, and conspiracy theories. This is undeniably a positive and worthwhile endeavor, but the phrase unlearned truth seems to be in direct contradiction. Could it not be that we are in fact already in the process of unlearning truth precisely because of fake news and propaganda on social media? If anything of such kind is happening, we must try to understand the reality and should be actively relearning the truth. Truth must prevail, and ultimately truth prevails, maybe on the cost of so many things. Let us discuss how to unlearn the hard, confined and constructive rules of conventional living. If you have understood things and you want to unlearn something, follow these simple steps. The first step is to escape your mind. Turn off the inner voice. According to Eckhart Tolle, virtually everyone hears a voice or several voices in their head all the time. The involuntary thought processes that you don't realize you have the power to stop. So, unlearn the incessant thought, the inner narrative voice that critic, judges and comments on everything we see and do from morning until night. Rethink the assumed notion that this dialogue never stops. Focus on nothingness. Fix your attention upon openness. Make your mind steady and calm. Quiet the voice within your mind. Tell it to shut the hell up. Let there be quiet. Find freedom within your own head. The second step is elude attention. Live true to self. According to Lao Tzu, express yourself completely, then become the quiet. Unlearn living from interaction to interaction. Find, embrace, and concentrate upon aloneness. One of the greatest tragedies we can see in people is when someone lives only through others. In other words, one who qualifies his or her worth, value, and life based upon a relationship or social status with others. Human beings need others, but we do not and should not qualify our lives based upon how others perceive and accept us. Escape the eyes of others, rethink attention, embrace the quiet. The third step is push your limits, extend your boundaries, risk discomfort. According to Dennis Wheatley, our limitations and success will be based most often on your own expectations for ourselves. What the mind dwells upon, the body acts upon. What we perceive to be stopping us from achieving our goals, finding our happiness, and improving our lives are merely our perceptions of limitations. We must do homework on our perceptions and limitations and try to improve upon. Take a pen and paper and journal a list of 10 things that you identify as limiting you or holding you back. Now that you have already listed them, unlearn them. Flip the fear of change into a compelling need of change. Flip fear of failure into failing on purpose so you can recover and realize failure is not a big deal at all. What are your boundaries, your limitations? These limits are not breaking points, points of no return, after which we collapse, die, or cease to exist, but merely indicating lines that show us where we can expand and extend our personal boundaries of growth and inner development. Unlearn comfort, risk discomfort, push the boundaries, rethink your potential and widen them. Now the fourth step is be fluid, be open, be free. According to Tsao Te Ching, water is fluid, soft and yielding, but water will wear away rock, which is rigid and cannot yield. As a rule, whatever is fluid, soft and yielding will overcome whatever is rigid and hard. This is another paradox. What is soft is strong. Freedom takes many forms, but never just one. Freedom is openness, not a series of strategies or rules to live by. Freedom is fluidity, not confining ourselves to perceived notion of living. Unlearn that living like a rock will protect you from the elements. Be fluid like the water, strong but malleable. Unlearn what we call strength. Rethink what we call freedom. Discard something learned, especially a bad habit or false or outdated information from one's memory. As teachers are being asked to unlearn rigid rules for labeling and placing children, we must keep all these things in our mind. So friends, we must remember that the problem created by a particular set of thinking is not capable enough of solving the same problem. So your thinking and learning process should be altered accordingly based on the situation. The best part is that practicing unlearning will make it easier and quicker to oscillate as your brain adapts. Unlearning is part of learning. We may recall when we were in school, our teachers taught us something new, and the week after, they told us it is not the best way to solve that particular problem. Now, solve the same problem using this particular method. This is unlearning followed by relearning. So friends, let's summarize what we have discussed today. So we have discussed about the learning, unlearning and relearning, and we have come to know that all these three are very important for our growth and development in all walks of life. As Darwin rightly said, it is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent. It is the one that is the most adaptable to change. There are numerous brands which did not evolve with the times and hence were reduced to nothing. It is imperative for us to follow the mantra, learn, unlearn and relearn. This will ensure we stay relevant and help us devise successful strategies. Change is the only constant, and one needs to understand that learning is essential for anyone who wants to thrive as well as grow and develop. So friends, these are some of the references and attributions which I have consulted during the preparation of this presentation. With this, I thank you all for patient listening and wish to see you in the next presentation. Thank you so much.
Dear students, we have discussed a very important topic of learning, unlearning and relearning in this video. Thank you, Professor Jaseem Ahmed, for discussing this very important topic. This video lecture was recorded by faculty at home during the national lockdown period for COVID-19 pandemic using minimal technical resources. Technical errors, if any, are unintentional and may please be ignored. For any queries with regard to this lecture or broadcast, kindly send your email to techsupport@dth.ac.in. Thank you so much.